Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Tuesday, July 30th, 2013. In the pre-market this morning, we've got Dow futures up about 30, S&P 500 futures up 4. At the same time, we've got both crude oil and gold trading lower this morning. So we are looking for a quiet open at 9:30 Tuesday morning. Just a quick reminder, we're on a summertime video schedule, so videos just Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and I'll be rotating between covering the U.S. and the Canadian markets. Let's start off this morning's show with a quick invitation. We have a new blog coming out in September called FM Charts. FM stands for Fast Money. That's CNBC's show that's at 5 o'clock p.m. Eastern time each day. And in the blog, we're going to be posting charts related to some of the stocks they talk about in the show. The site's in early beta. We still have to work out some of the links and things in the site. But certainly last night's post will work. And so if you want to stop by and check out fmcharts.net, you're certainly welcome to do that. And again, we'll be releasing this site to the public in September, but it's fmcharts.net. It's a Fed day today. It's a Fed day tomorrow, so things will be fairly quiet. We've been watching the S&P 500, see if we can get up and over 1687.50 for the past couple of weeks. And we've been able to trade above it, but we're pretty well stuck there. We've been also watching the Dow, see if it could get up and over 15,625. And again, we're having trouble getting through that resistance. At the same time, no need to worry. We've been talking about the VIX and looking for a breakout above the upper channel line. That breakout level has continued to fall, and right now we traded up to the upper channel line yesterday, but we're still looking for a close above 1386 to give us a new buy signal for the VIX, and that certainly would be a reason to become concerned about the stock market. Looking at overnight activity, fairly quiet in Australia, new sell signal in New Zealand, very small market, but certainly once the overseas markets start to add up sell signals, that can certainly put downward pressure on North America. Fairly quiet in Hong Kong overnight, Shanghai on a sell signal, Tokyo still on a sell signal. Had another reversal day yesterday. We've got a nice open gap there. In fact, we've got two that could potentially act as a resistance on the way up. We've got one there and one up there. And so two open gaps that could potentially act as resistance on the way up. I talked about the Indian market putting in a double top, and we're still seeing a fall through to the downside in that market. Looking at commodities, and we're looking at the U.S. ETFs. Somebody asked me the other day, do I actually trade copper? And the answer is no, I do not trade copper, but I watch it like a hawk. It's a global economic barometer and has a lot to do with construction around the world and manufacturing. And if copper is being sold off, then people do not have an optimistic view of the global economy. And so here we are once again. Moved up to the 50-day moving average and reversed, moved up to the bottom of the flypaper channel and reversed. And so people would be a lot more excited about the global economy if we had copper above the flypaper channel. Looking at the GLD, quiet day yesterday, inside day. Big area of resistance here is the 131.25 level. It acted as support, then it finally broke, and that was the last down move in gold. And so now we're looking to see if we can get up and over 131.25. If we can, that would certainly be very optimistic for the gold market. Silver, nothing going on there. Didn't even get near the 50-day moving average and nowhere near the flypaper channel. So on a positive note, we still have a lot of room to the upside for silver before anybody gets overly stressed out. We certainly have an open gap here, but we've got a big one up here that could potentially act as a target at some point in the future. Now, the energy sector, we've got crude oil on a sell signal, gasoline on a sell signal, and natural gas on a sell signal. Natural gas ran into the moving average convergence and reversed, and now it looks like we're going back down to test the winter lows for natural gas. Next up, let's take a look at the U.S. market, and S&P 500 had an inside day on Monday. A close on Tuesday below 1677.63 would give us a sell signal. Not expecting that to happen on Tuesday. It's a Fed day, and really nothing's going to happen until after 2 p.m. tomorrow. So for the VIX, of course, we're looking for a close above 1386. For the NASDAQ 100, a close below 3040.23 would give us a new sell signal on Tuesday, and a VIX above 1287 would certainly be a concern. Bank stocks traded down into the channel, traded down to the lower channel line yesterday, so a close for the Dow Jones Banking Index below 285.30 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. And we're seeing some weakness in most of the major bank stocks. Looks like they've topped, but still waiting for confirmation to the downside. So a close below 14.36 for Bank of America would give us a sell signal, 31.10 for Bank of New York. We've got Citibank right on the edge of a new sell signal. A close below 51.55 would do that on Tuesday. JP Morgan, a close below 55.55 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. KeyBank, 11.96. We've got SunTrust trading in the channel. A close below 34.22 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Wells Fargo already on a sell signal. A close above 44.07 would undo that. Canadian banks still performing very well. British banks, we had Barclays rollover on Monday. Credit Suisse traded back into the channel yesterday. A close below 29.16 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Deutsche Bank, we're looking at a close below 45.95 to generate a sell signal on Tuesday. If you look at any of these banks, you can see we've got Credit Suisse traded up to the May highs, traded a little above, and then started to reverse. We've got Deutsche Bank, couldn't make it all the way up to the May highs before starting to pull back, and we've got it on a new early warning signal. So we had an early warning signal here, that was the top of that move. We had an early warning signal here, that was the top of that move. And now we've got a new early warning signal for Deutsche Bank. So I think that you're probably seeing the top of this move in the banking sector. Now, gold stocks have a new early warning signal in the XAU. We've been able to move up and trade over 100, but really we're locked at 100 right now on the XAU. We've got an open gap that could potentially act as support on the way down, and that support level is going to be above the lower channel line, and so we'd be really concerned if we started to see the XAU close below 94.83. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple 60-minute charts. We've got the VIX trading in the flypaper channel right now. Of course, you can see just visually there, if we break out above 14, that would be a concern. So we talk about the fact that if the VIX is below the flypaper channel, the market's bullish. And essentially, the market's content when you've got the VIX below the flypaper channel. When it's above it, of course, people become bearish or concerned. And so if you don't like the words bullish and bearish, just think about content and concerned. And then the opposite is true, of course, for the S&P 500. If it's above the flypaper channel, people are content. If it's below, people are concerned. And you can see we're right above the flypaper channel, basically stuck to it at the moment. We're currently trading around the 50-hour moving average, so we've got the 100 and 200-hour as potential areas of support on the way down. We're currently on an intraday sell signal, and close above 1691 would give us an intraday buy signal on Tuesday. Okay, folks, that's all for Tuesday morning. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Thursday morning.